Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I am going to discuss the ways to convert an object to a primitive. Actually, JavaScript has already provided two methods. One is called toString, and the other one is called valueOf, in order to do the conversion for us. But by default, they are not able to do the things pretty well. That's why we have to propose two methods to address the problems. The first one is to use a symbol called Symbol.toPrimitive so that we can do the object conversion. And the other way is to override the given toString and valueOf methods. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is very simple. It just contains a title and a heading. And it is linked to a certain JavaScript file called myscript.js, which is put in the JS folder. In order for me to use the struct mode, I have to say use struct at the very beginning of the JavaScript file. Now, let us go to the topic for today. Actually, objects can be converted according to the hints given by the objects. An object can have three possible hints. One is called a string, one is called a number, and the other one is called default. And I'm going to discuss these three hints later on. And actually, in principle, the conversion is just based on the property type of your object. And we will investigate this one now. Suppose I have a car object. At this stage, I have a key value pair called make, and the value is a string. And in general, if I want to convert this particular object to a string or to a number, we can say that it is quite natural to think about it as converting it to a string, because you can see the value is actually a string. So let us see if it is possible to do so by using the toString method, which is a built-in method in JavaScript. See, I'm able to do the conversion directly using the toString method. Save. Reload. The conversion cannot be done so easily. You can see that the conversion gives me an object, but you would expect that the value of the car, which is in the form of a string, is returned after using the toString method. So you can see that the default toString method isn't so ideal in doing the conversion so directly. How about printing the car content directly using the alert window? Let us see. Let me save it. Save. Save. Reload. You can see that when I just print out the content of a car, I would get an object, because the car is actually an object. And you can see that the result is the same as that provided by the toString method. Okay, now you can see that both alert windows just give you object. So you can also see that when I print out the car content directly, I'm able to just call the toString method. But of course, the answer coming from these two alert windows is not so ideal, or it is not so useful to us. How about valueOf? Of course, when I have a key value pair whose value is not a number, you can expect that the valueOf method cannot give you something pretty useful. Let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you can also see that I would get an object. So you can see that the valueOf method would just return the object itself. So what would be the situation if the content of the car has a key value pair that has a number inside the value? Let's see. Now, I have a key value pair whose value is a number. So would you expect that the valueOf method would return 2017 as the output? Let us see. Save. Reload. You can also see that the valueOf method just returns an object. So you can see that the valueOf method and the toString method are both not pretty good at doing the conversion that all of us can understand easily. So we can see that both the toString method and the valueOf method cannot do the conversion pretty well. That's why we have to think about other ways to address the problem with the two methods. The first approach is to use a built-in symbol called Symbol.toPrimitive. Now let us see an example, which is helping us to understand the mechanism better. So suppose I've already got an object. I have a key value pair whose value is a string, and I have another key value pair which has a number in the value part. So if I want to do the conversion of the object to a primitive, it is sensible to check whether your primitive value is a string or a number. So my task is to use a symbol, which is a built-in one, to address this issue. So I'm going to write a function for the conversion based on the hint. So you can see that I have two possible hints. One is the string and the other is a number. And I'm able to do the conversion so that I can return the converted type using my following function. Now I have set up a function which uses a built-in symbol called symbol.toPrimitive, and I'm able to pass a certain hint to this function, and I'm able to check the nature of this hint. If the hint is a number, I will just return the length by using the this keyword. So in this case, I'm able to do the valueOf approach. And if the hint is really a string instead of a number, I will just return the color part, which is simply having a string as being the value. In this case, I'm just able to use the toString function properly. Okay. And as I said, we have three possible hints: string, number, and default. So for completeness, I have to handle the default case as well. How can I do it? Let me show you now. Okay, if the hint is not a number or it is not a string, I will just do something else. For example, I can return hello being the function output. So I don't output the corresponding value of some key. I just return something else to indicate that the hint is actually other than a string or a number. Okay, so let us play with this conversion here. If JavaScript sees an object, the system.toPrimitive symbol will try to treat it as a string first. So let me see an example right now. So you see, the alert window has been given a certain object called apple. And by default, the conversion will try to convert it to a string first. So you can expect that the color would be output because the color is simply a certain string value. Okay, so let me see. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that red is coming out because at this stage I'm just returning the string value of the color key because the color key is simply a string. Okay, so if I'm able to change the object to a certain number, you can expect that the number hint will dominate and the number would be output. So let me see the result. If I add a plus sign, I'm able to change an object to a number. So now the alert window is going to treat it as a number. So when the object becomes a number, this hint dominates and I would just print out the length, which is a number. So in this case, I'm acting the valueOf method of a certain object. So let me see. Save. reload. Yes, you can see 12 is coming out. In this case, you have a number hint, and that number hint is going to return the length of an apple, which is 12 cm, for example, or centimeters, for example. So in this case, if an object becomes a number, you have to try the number hint. If the object is not a pure one, or it is not a number, the Symbol.toPrimitive symbol is going to try the default hint. Let me show you an example. Now, the content of the alert window is something other than an object. So you can see that an object is going to add a string. So the content here is neither a pure object nor a number. In this case, you can expect that I would do the else part shown here. So the previous two if parts are not executed. So we can see the result now. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see hello is coming out because I'm now doing the else part of my function. So it is the case for the default hints. So when the hint is neither a number nor a string, you do the default hints. So this is a way of converting an object into a primitive according to the key value pair that it has. And this is the first method, and I'm going to tell you the second method. The other method is more direct. I'm able to overwrite the toString method and the valueOf method. As we can see that the original toString methods are not good at giving us some useful results. That's why we are trying to do the overriding. How can we do the overriding? Let me show you now. Now you can see that I have an object called lemon. A lemon has its color, which is yellow, and it has its length, which is 8, for example, cm. So if I want to do the object conversion more easily, I can just override the toString method. And you can see the overriding is quite easy. I just set up a function in the object, and the toString method is going to give me the string value, which is yellow. And the valueOf method is just giving me the number, which is 8 here. So how can I use it? I can show you now. If I want to up a string, of course I have to use the toString method. And you can expect that yellow would come out because the toString method just gives me a string value coming from the color key. So let me try it now. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see yellow is coming out because now I use the toString method directly, even though I don't say it explicitly. Remember that when I don't use the toString method, the result is the same as the one using the toString method shown here. So that's why I don't have to say toString here, even though it is still allowed to do so. And if I want to output a number coming from an object, how can I do it? I just use the previous approach called plus object. Let me show you now. Now I have a plus sign before the object name. So when I add a plus sign, it is going to treat the object as a number. And when you treat an object as a number, I will try to call the valueOf method, which is an overwritten one. So save. Reload. Yes, you can see 8 is coming out because it is treated as a number. And when it is treated as a number, I would use the valueOf function shown here. That's why I would just give out the length of the lemon, which is 8 cm. If I want to do some arithmetic operation of a certain object, of course you would expect that the object conversion is performed first. So let me show you an example. Now I'm able to do the subtraction so that I'm able to find out lemon minus 2. Lemon is now an object, but when you want to subtract 2 from an object, it is sensible to convert the object to a number before we can do the subtraction. That's why when I have this expression, I will just call the valueOf method of the lemon object to convert it to 8, and then I would get 8 minus 2, which is equal to 6. So let me see the result. Save. Reload. Yes, I'm able to get 6 because lemon is converted to a number which is 8 before I do the subtraction, which is a kind of arithmetic operation. So this video has already discussed the ways to really do the object conversion to a primitive. We have addressed the shortcoming of the built-in toString method and the valueOf method. That's why we have to use other approaches to really convert an object to some useful primitives. The first approach is to use the Symbol.toPrimitive symbol, and I'm able to set up a function that uses this symbol, and the function is able to help us change the content of an object to a string or number according to the hint provided to the function. Okay, and the second one is just use the overriding of the toString method and the valueOf method. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.